She just shot. I was gonna like vlog this whole thing initially, but then I got like ridiculously sick yesterday for some reason. Still feel like complete shit. Yeah, I didn't even like, I was so lazy and sore and in pain. I didn't even clean my place. So I'm coming back to a filthy fucking house naturally. Where's my straw? Okay, I don't know where the fuck my straw is. I'm not just drinking the Red Bull like that. Like, low-key, my body, I feel like I want to throw up. But, like, you know, we move. It's only Thursday, my show. I wanted to take this wig back, like, with so badly. But the motherfucker can't fit in my bags. Because my bag, that motherfucker over there, decided it's going to break. So now I can't move it with the wheels. Now I have to have two smaller bags. Which is going to cost me 259 extra. So we're really starting this trip off good. But yeah, I'm still like, low-key, I can leave now, but I'm like dwelling because I'm so convinced I'm forgetting something. But like, I don't know what that is. And at this point, it is what it is, be what it be, it all what it all. Mind you, this is only my second time ever flying. So I'm kind of nervous, bruh. Because with my luck, my bro, frick. 9/11. Struggling to push these bags because they are full of shit, but I'm at an airport. I've been here for a while. I just crunched some hours with work also, just downloaded my reports and stuff for the day so that that's done. So now I'm just gonna check my luggage in. What a blessed day to be a faggot, because they told me that this suitcase is big enough for hand luggage, so I don't have to pay that extra money. Hello. Look how cool this looks. I love you, baby. Stuff is for me, girl, because turbulence. No, ma'am. I almost cucked myself in the plane. Girl, get me a Greyhound next time. No, I'm lying. I enjoyed it, but it's not my favorite. It's kind of scary. Kind of like it. Kind of don't. Got my bags. Let me go meet Adam.
She got flown, honey. Not you getting my hunch in the video.
Not the hunch.
Very much the hunch.
Apparently, Joburg on my way or close by is 25 minutes away, according to Adam.
It's true. I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay.
You have a show in Pretoria tomorrow, don't you?
Girl, let's talk. Guys, I haven't been vlogging because this flu has been kicking my ass, my bro. So yesterday, I basically just settled in. I fell asleep like on the bed because I got in and was load shedding. Fell asleep and like woke up like 3 hours later. Made a new friend though. Duck of me. But yeah, I couldn't even get any work done yesterday because I also overslept to the point where I didn't have time to go to the shop to go buy hairspray and craft paper and the things I need to like finish, because I was thinking like, oh god, I can't take the stuff on the plane, just now it's gonna bomb. So now I must go spend money. The flu is low-key kicking my ass still. Like, I'm working and I'm like trying to like do what I can do, but like I can't like sit up for longer than like 10 minutes. I can't stand like 10 minutes. Work people is working on my nerves. It's just stress everywhere and I've got like no time, so I'm like borderline over it, but I'm just trying to like keep going. But like everything is so far here in Joburg. I don't like Joburg. I decided it's warm, everything is far, Uber's so expensive, not for me. But it's cute. It's cute, I'm not gonna lie. Let me show you Adam's wigs. Oh my god, stunning. So this is Adam's drag room. This bitch got more wigs than me. Like, I mean, sorted. Like, I think my body's like burnt out from work, from drag, from everything. And my body just wants to rest. Because even now, I just stood up for like 2 minutes. And my body's like, bitch, go back to bed. My body's done with me. I haven't taken a shit in 5 days. Every time I go to the toilet, it's just one poop. Is this a heel? Come on, Halloween. It's giving endangered species. Okay, Adam's house help just live. So, I'm gonna get done quickly. Just to go to the shop so I can get the stuff I need. I'm out of breath and I just walked up the stairs. Like, this is insane. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with me. I can't eat. I get mad when I eat. I ate a pie yesterday and I almost threw it up like while I was eating. It was so disgusting. But I forced myself to eat it. And now I had like a salad that I bought yesterday. Noodle salad. And I still feel mad ever since I ate that salad. I don't know what is going on with me. What the fuck is happening, my bro? I don't need this. Not today. Not when the flights were booked. Not when the booking was made. Not when there's money on the line. Girl, I'm not taking the bag because this is Joburg and I've heard things. So I'm just taking my card. Good girl. And my phone. Did I really need like a fancy pack, no? Or something. Let me just reply to the work people because they're also trying me. I really wish I felt better. And this is now the true tea. Like, I'm always grateful for new experiences, but I'm having the worst experience right now. I'm just not feeling any type of spirit. No problem, let's check Monday. Cute, glamour, close the laptop, done with work, over it. I don't know how to lock this place. Where's the keys? Do these people not lock their gates? This is definitely not Cape Town, bro. Also, how does anyone get things done in Joburg, my bro? Like, yeah, you must have a car. Facts. Because Uber for 100 rand, like, just around the corner. Girl, fuck that. That shit's not gonna work in Cape Town. I'm gonna have to take a bag with. Girl, let me just take, like, I've got this denim shirt that has, like, pockets in. Maybe that will help. And, of course, now that the Uber's on its way, I've got a cuck. Let me just wash my hands, because that wasn't even worth calling a cuck. That was just, like, a pfft, done. At least I feel better than I did yesterday. Adam taught me how to drink made lemon with ginger beer, Stony. And I hate Stony, but, it actually worked, I'm not gonna lie. I'm actually gonna do that again. So I'm actually gonna take a made lemon with me. Almost forgot my card and my key. But yeah, not much happened yesterday. We were just kicking, we were just talking, because Adam and I don't really know each other. So it was just a bunch of fags fagging out, trying to, like, you know how we are. We try to, like, play the levels and see how we respond to each other. But I'm a very easy grill. I am very quiet, but, like, at the same time, I'm an open book. Like, what you see is what you get. I don't have any facades for anyone. Yeah, and sometimes people don't like my sense of humor. And not my problem. But yeah, the only reason I'm, like, acting a fucking fool now is because I'm trying to, like, hype my damn self up and not get anxious about the fact that I'm literally taking an Uber in a fucking city I've never been to before. So, girl. Panique to your order, girl. I feel like I need to, like, just take myself out because I'm actually in a very terrible mood. I don't know if you can tell. And when I'm in a terrible mood, I'm not the best person to be around because my mood swings are rather tangible, so to speak. So it's making me really difficult for me to even interact with people. So I hate when I'm sick. I'm the worst fucking person. So I just know come tomorrow. Oh God, I'm not going to survive. But we'll get there. Anyway, my Uber's almost here because he drove 2 kilometers from 2 kilometers away. Why is everything so far in Joburg? Here. God, it's awkward. I'm at Christa Shopping Mall now. I don't know what if that's the name. I didn't record in the Chinatown because it was a bit rope and girl coming from me. No, but I'm just like a sketchy person in general. So I just don't pull out my phone anywhere, not even in Cape Town. Go. I'm confused. I just woke up. Like, my mouth is still sticky. I didn't vlog yesterday because when I got home from the mall, God, I had like 2 hours and it was load shedding. So I just kind of got like what I could get done. I styled this wig yesterday. My throat and nose is so sore today. And I have to get ready in an hour for the brunch. Everyone is like still asleep. I'm still looking this year. Yo, I look like shit, nigga. I feel like shit as well, if I'm gonna be honest. Waking up next to Wade is not cute. I kind of like packed my bag yesterday already, so that is done. So I basically have to just shower, shave, and do my makeup. And then I'm basically ready. My concern is I'm a little bit bloated because I have not passed stool since yesterday, but that was like one draw, you know what I mean? But I've not passed proper stool in like almost a week. Chronic constipation will get you, girl. I'm a bit worried. Because that means it's going to be painful. And I don't have laxatives. And if I take any now, it's gonna go. Imagine I take one now and then laxatives only kick in like at the gig. Not cute. Look at this moose jar of sugar. Adam says he doesn't drink coffee, so I bought me a small coffee because you're not gonna get me girl. Couldn't sleep last night. I was up till about 2. So I don't know why I couldn't sleep. I think my brain was just more awake than what I was, thinking about everything that needs to be done today. But at least I'm packed so I can like waste a little bit of time, just a little bit. But yeah, let me get my shit together. Have my morning coffee, brush my back, shower, force a cack. Maybe I will steal a bit of milk. Adam, when you see this, I stole a little bit of milk. Because this is probably the only thing that's gonna make me shit. And of course, for breakfast, I'm telling you, the shit I put my body through for like being gay. My body can't do this anymore. My body's been telling me not to do this for a while. Here I am. I better fucking get dipped. It's so weird being the first one awake. Like, I hate going to people's houses. And like, I'm awake first because then I don't know what to do with myself. But thankfully I got like a room to myself. So I can basically like take a rook if I want to, but like I'm not even in that room. If I take a rook now, girl, no one is getting a single split out of me, not even a twirl. I learned during my dance days already, like don't do sex. Am I like 4? Don't have sex, don't jerk off, don't do anything sexual the day of a competition, because girl, your knees are like, whether you're top or bottom, girl, I was a top then. I still don't have a top. God, let's not go there. But yeah, I'm trying, as you can hear, because my voice in the morning is like way deeper than it needs to be. So I'm trying not to speak too loud, otherwise I will vibrate the shit out of this house. But yeah, I think I'm gonna put on House of the Dragon and just like drink my coffee, watch a few YouTube videos, drink my coffee, you know, get into the spirit, wake up basically. So I'll see you guys later. Also, I know I'm like terrible at this vlog thing, but when I get busy, I like it like, don't touch me busy. I actually had this very cool conversation last night with Adam at the table. We like smoked a joint and we're like just talking about drag and how Joburg and Cape Town differs, and I realized how traditional and cultural Cape Town drag is and how young Joburg drag is. Like Adam says, the first queen year was like in 2019. Like, we're not counting the old dragoons, we're counting like this new age queens. And like, ours go way back. Like, so it was a very interesting conversation, put a lot into perspective. And I feel like it's a conversation that queens don't necessarily have. And now Adam was trying to be very general about it, as to not be specific. Well, obviously, but I mean, general in the sense that, what does Cape Town feel about Joburg? And I could not answer it because I don't even really like mingle too much with the Cape Town girls. When I do, we don't converse to that extreme. This is my first experience of Joburg, and I'm actually quite happy that I get to do it without any prejudice or like, you know, vibes. So this is just my first time and I'm gonna enjoy it. Hopefully I feel better, because I would actually like to go out tonight. Girl, the fucking Babylon show is like 12, bro. Who has a show at 12? A drag show. It's one song though, but it's fine. Now I must get ready at that time, bro. Because Lord knows, I'm not going to fucking put on a face for brunch and keep it until the night. Y'all got me fucked up.
The girl! We at the gate! No, I'm kind of like vlogging it also, because I want to like make like a video.
Oh yeah, it'll be cute.
So, these are apparently all the dumb bottoms here in the show.
Well, I can be too warm in.
You heard it here first. Twitter! Adrian's a hoe.
Walk away.
Girl, we are post-gig.
I've
got Miss Godfrey, Miss Wig Whisperer. She whispered into my wig and my wig collapsed.
It fell off and took your edges.
Girl!
Wait, aim that camera at me. Y'all want to see some real shit?
Don't you dare! Don't you dare!
Did she just pull that fucking out of there?
Out
from the wig.
Her lace.
200 Get into that.
It's an investment.
That's
this
what happens.
Fucking slut.
That's what happens. Yeah, that's called tax evasion. Sarge doesn't know what's over here.
It's cryptocurrency.
Oh my god. Firstly, Theo is driving.
And he's concussed.
And Mam has a concussion. Diagnosed. Concussion.
Like, I'm not so. Oh my god, no.
Sir.
Yeah,
this is how much we care about our life.
She's
girl.
She's driving as a straight woman.
I was sweating. I don't understand. It's raining in Joburg. And I am wet, like soaking wet, sweating.
She's that snail. Do you like these
words? Godfrey said, I'm going to go out and I'm going to be a teal bitch.
Girl, I know it goes with nothing, but I go with everybody.
No, it actually looks so stunning because you're wearing like all black.
It gives?
It does.
I'm also a Disney.
I love you watching me wear it for like my second
you shut up. I would have snatched this bitch the fuck off and given it to you. Yeah. I'm also auditioning husbands, so.
Auditioning?
Yeah.
Not auditioning.
I'm auditioning husbands.
Straight husbands, no boyfriends.
Oh, no, not straight people.
No, I don't mean. No, you. Okay. They shit on your dick.
Okay. Done.
You know how this gig was long?
Yeah.
My fucking beard's growing back, bitch.
Her stubble is back. That is such a white people thing. If I shave, it takes me 3 weeks to even feel anything.
Bitch, get into it. I literally just took my makeup off. The gig was a pet C. I'm actually so bummed that my flight is so early tomorrow because I would have loved to have spent more time tonight, like, petting and, like, having such a good time with the girls. I've met Sally before, met Adrian and Ash. It was such a fun time just seeing people who I know from, like, social media and stuff. I don't think I know Ash at all, but, like, I know him now. Lorenzo was also there. So, it was a vibe. So, yeah. I'm actually quite tired. I wonder if I should take a nap. I do have time. However, everyone is going to Bianca's show tonight. So, I'm going to be alone and I have to Uber. So, I'm, like, trying so hard to, like, find a queen in Cape Town who I'm just, like, can I come to you and can I come paint there or whatever? But everyone is going. So I'm like gonna have to like Uber alone from here to Babylon tonight. It's not of a hype in drag. And check this, it's like load shedding at 8. How the fuck? The gig is only at like after 11. So I'm a little bit, like, annoyed with that. I'm actually quite tired. I'm not gonna lie. But hey. But yeah, it was such a fun time. I tried to take videos, but girl, I didn't even have my phone. Also, last, if you're watching this, thank you so much for like running around and helping me. I appreciate it so, so much. Like, I'm gonna make you so sick tonight. But yeah, hopefully tonight is a vibe as well. Made some good tips also, which was very good. I'm always grateful. Both on the yoga and in cash. So, vibes. So yeah, we were trying to like get my flight extended to like a later hour, but like I can't. Like, it's like almost 2,000 to like get an extension to 4 o'clock. Just, I didn't wash my nun's habit, so anyone at Babylon tonight, if there's like stains of makeup on my nun's habit, forgive me. It's been a wild couple of days. I just did not get time to get around to it. But yeah, let me go and, you know, prepare for tonight. My skin hates me, so let me go wash my face and like do what I need to do. Not you also seeing my group areas act hey. Classic for this world, forever I'm that girl. Beat you diamonds and pearl. Oh baby, I'm too classy to be touched. I pick them all in dust. I'm stingy with my love. Oh baby,
this is Joburg's biggest hoor. Not the jump scare.
Bitch. Bro, I can't take myself serious even I don't have beard. I am late. I might miss my flight. Not gonna be a vibe. Uber driver is just putting in petrol, but like it's, what's the time? It's 8:38. My flight is at 9:35. Go. Look at this. Jason must be fucking flight. Mm-hmm. So I'm at the sales counter on. Says she missed the flight, so I am currently waiting. They're closing the gates for the next flight at like 9:45, and it's like now, and so they're just like waiting to see if they can help me. But yeah, hopefully shit goes well. But like, it's like, yeah, I had to pay like 300 rand, which is not a lot, but like, girl, I can do a lot with 300 rand, sis. I'm from the plane, I can make 300 and turn 3,000, maybe. So I'm just like waiting, I'm slamming it out here. I can't even like go buy me water because like, probably gonna have to get something like on the flight if I get a fucking flight. It's like fully booked to Cape Town. Why so many people go to Cape Town? Period. Like, but this is not a vibe. No. Here we go. sad. Bitch, this might be my last flight ever. So let's document the whole period. I know Fly Safari, I know they got a bad fucking rip, but like, you know, it is what it is. A bitch is still on the wings. So fucking loud. I feel good for someone who bubble us. My skin doesn't though. Just landed in Cape Town. Feels like little bit back. I can't even explain how excited I am to like sleep in my own bed. I didn't realize I was such a homebody until this trip. And I'm not mad at it. Come on, new me. Because, God, the last place I would ever want to be is home. And now the only place I want to be is home. But, yeah, I slept on the flight a bit, as you can see. But I didn't get I missed my flight, so I had priority booking and a window seat. But then, because I missed the flight and I had to pay $300 extra and be put on standby, I lost priority, so I had to stand in this line for too long. And then I also lost my window seat. And this guy was like a big guy that was like next to me. So I was like, girl, I can't even see, I can't even take pictures for girl. So that's why there's no video. But yeah, I'm gonna get something to eat because I know damn well I'm not gonna make myself something to eat. And then I'm gonna go home. I'll speak to you now. I just realized I didn't really like finish the vlog yesterday because the moment I got home, girl, I fucking passed out. I was over. But yeah, I'm just gonna, I know a lot of this vlog has kind of just been me talking the whole time. Let me get my coffee. And yeah, a lot of it has been me talking, a lot of it has just not been like videos of the actual experience because I was literally so fucking sick. I literally excused myself from company for the most part. And I was sleeping a lot of the time, or I was running around a lot of the time. But I had a fucking amazing time. There's no other way to explain it. The people in Joburg are on another level. you guys really came through for the girls. The Friday night, the Saturday, basically, I can just summarize. I basically didn't take a lot of videos because the performance happened so quick. And I was actually very fucking nervous because I had to get ready in load shedding. Firstly, I had to do my makeup in load shedding. So I had a phone torch, literally, to do my makeup. And yeah, I was exhausted. I was so high on meds because my body was just, I was just done for. And I learned my lyrics and everything just went out the door, my bro. I literally was mumbling after that because I was so tired. My body was moving, but my brain was just like that. Does that make sense? But either way, we had a fucking patsy. And I missed my damn flight. But hopefully I see the Joburg girls soon. And now that you know that I'm vlogging, please, when you see me, tell me, bitch, take your phone out, I want to be in the vlog, because I'm gonna forget. But no, again, I just want to say thank you to Adam for booking me and getting me on that side of the world. I want to say thank you to Street Bar for hosting us, and also Babylon. You guys are amazing. Like, such good treatment, such nice people. I want to say a big thank you to Michael as well, Adam's partner, for being such a helping hand, carrying bags and running around with the yoga machine. It meant a lot. And then a huge special shout out to, I hate living here, a big a big thank you to She Is Lust Vegas for being the absolute sweetest doll I've ever met. This hoe is in full drag and like, do you need anything? Do you want something? Do you need me to do this? Let me run for you quickly. Like, bitch, sit your ass down and be the queen you are. No, but oh my gosh, she was such a sweetheart, running around at the brunch like with my bag. You are amazing, Lust Vegas, and I cannot wait to spend more time with you. And I can't wait till you come to Cape Town, to Cape Town, because, girl, I'm gonna hopefully be able to return the favor to you. Yeah, and a big special shout out to Adrian as well for driving my ass around for Babylon's gig. Even though you left early, you bitch. I will forever hold that against you. But next time, we're going to proper Patsy, and hopefully I don't have the fucking flu. So I can spend time with you guys outside of drag and, you know, Kiki, walk to the malls, go to Chinatown, all of that stuff. And show me what Joburg is like. Goldring City! That's where I want to go next. So take me there. Yeah, I'm really excited to go back to Joburg eventually. Adam and I are already in talks of it. So we'll see you soon. But yeah, thank you once again for watching this video also. I know I talk a lot of shit, but it really was an amazing experience. And I'm so grateful to everyone who had a share in it. You guys made my trip so much fun. Thank you. Also, another few shout-outs just to Sally Work. And Sally, firstly, bitch, why the fuck are you not in Babylon? Let's discuss that. Secondly, I also want to say thank you to Sean and Lorenzo. You know how special it is to have Cape Town, like, with you there? It's like a different experience. Or maybe I'm just a fucking senti bitch. But, yeah, I was very grateful to have a piece of home with me. So, yeah, bye. This is the end of the vlog. I'll see you next time, Joburg.